Before I start, I would just like to thank Hope for making me realize there is nothing I can't do.
Feeling nothing more than feeling, trying to forget.
Remember when I was talking to you about, you know, encouraging people?
Trying to forget my feelings of love.
Well, seeing Kathy sing tonight.
Feeling, woo-woo-woo, feeling, woo-woo-woo, feel you again in my heart.
Maybe I'm a little too encouraging.
Okay, Mom, we're having this meeting to talk about your situation. Have you spoken to your lawyer?
I'm sort of between lawyers right now.
But what about Pablo Ramirez? You used him for years.
Well, after I fucked him, we decided not to do business together.
Well, we could help you find a new lawyer.
I think I'm going to lay low here for a while and see if this whole thing doesn't just blow over.
Yeah, what the hell? It's just rape.
Well, Mom, that might be tough for us because, well, Hank and I have something that we need to tell you. Mom, Hank and I are trying to... Oh, my God! Hank, call 911!
It's okay.
Oh, my God, Mom!
Melissa, Mom. It's okay. Everything's fine. I drugged her.
He's not dead. Right?
Hard to say.
Poke him.
No! If we poke him and he wakes up, he'll just start crying and screaming again.
What? I'm his godmother. I need to know if he's dead or alive.
Okay, so you poke him to see if he's not dead, and once you poke him, if he starts to scream, I'm leaving.
Oh, get him here.
You're a genius.
I would be a really bad mom.
And you would be a genius, Mom. Pulling that mirror idea out of your ass? You're like a mother savant. Rain, Mom. Shit, mothering isn't all tugs and kisses and what is that thing when you feel protective about someone?
Caring?
Empathy. It's not all empathy. Some of it is just good common sense. Poke him awake and he gets shocked and jarred and probably scarred for life. You saved him from that here.
Yeah. Alive. He's alive.
When my brother-in-law, Drew, first showed me the video, I didn't question it. Callie had always been a little fragile. Packing up her stuff and hiding out for a while, that sounded like her. But then after the days started turning into weeks, I got suspicious.
The marriage was troubled?
Callie had left him once before. That was about a year and a half ago.
What happened?
I don't know. Callie didn't even tell me she'd done it till a few weeks later, and by then, she and Drew were back together. I tried to get her to talk about it, but she said it was all in the past. She was like that. She kept everything bottled up, private. So when she didn't return my phone calls after Drew showed me the video, I wasn't surprised.
After a few weeks, Rebecca went to the police.
I had to slug her because she fought.
You hit her because you couldn't get it up.
That's a lie. I put a hole in her mattress.
You couldn't perform, so you got angry. That's why you cut her face.
That's a boning knife, sweetheart. I just want to see how it handled on human flesh.
I don't recognize him.
So, I guess you're here to see me, huh?
No. It was a nice try, though.
Nice try?
Yeah. There's something very heroic about a chief who's willing to draw all the negative attention onto himself and away from his men.
Well, you see, that's what a leader does.
Yeah. You know, this little charm act of yours didn't work on me the last time. Look, I've done my research, Chief Nelson. There are a lot of firefighters out there who don't like what's been going on in your crew for the last 10 years.
Okay.
Okay, I know that the conspiracy guy is not you. I know it's a good-looking guy with a cocky smile and the doomy dimples who believes that the government purposely brought down the Twin Towers as an excuse to attack an enemy in the Middle East. And I find that very interesting. America? Not so much. They want sex. Sex and drugs and murder. So the idea that Tommy Gavin slept with his dead cousin's wife for almost 7 years? Brilliant. And the fact that Tommy Gavin's wife had a baby with his murdered cop brother during the same period of time? Genius. This is the kind of story that can make someone like me a national name. Your firehouse may be considered the bottom of the barrel right now by the FDNY, but for me, it is a goddamn gold rush.
Well, you know, in Italian, there's a name for people like you.
Really? What's that?
Miserable bitch.
I've got work to do.
She's got me booked at the fertility center every other day.
Jacob Adler.
Have fun.